Well, really, thank you very much to all the speakers. I think the experience that they are explaining to us is very interesting because they are coming from different point of view. One of them from special troubles for the science centers or from the hospitals, another for the point of view of the activities related with the state, another coming from Europe, and really the other point of view very important from the companies, from the enterprise. Now we have an open time for your questions to the speakers. You are free to talk to him, and you are free to ask to them. Or you prefer, we can do it in Spanish. It's no. If you don't mind, I can translate to you. But probably it's easier for us. Como vulgueu, podem fer preguntes en català, en castellà, sense cap problema. I will try to help you, Ronnie.
Yes, just to get the question time going also. To set up the discussion on these public-private partnerships, PPPs, as the expert say, what I understood, and I like it, of the innovative medicine initiative was that you have the industry, you have the European Commission, and then you have a sort of arbiter, which is your own office in a way, your own organization. Here we tend to go more for a contract or convenio, we call it, which then is just followed by the two institutions. And because one of them is a public body, normally it is presumed that it will be fair and law-abiding, which is normally the case, right? But in your case, you have this third party. Is that the rule also in other countries to have a third party that when there is a big partnership is the arbiter?
I think it's a model that the European Commission has developed, but nothing prevents. It's a model that the European Commission has developed in the exercise of having EMI up and running. But this is a model which can be a national model too. So, and depending if you want to keep this at the national level, or if you want to have this as a European level, or any other regional level, which we don't say. But the issue is really to make the model as simple as possible, to make it easy to implement.
Not necessarily when it's not such a big scheme. So smaller schemes can also work on a sort of direct contract or agreement.
Definitely. I mean, it's the type of agreement that you made with your stakeholders.
Can you have
On this, I think in the case of IMI initiative, there are actually three actors, because the European Community is actively funding. So it's not just arbitrating, it's actively funding. It's very different.
No, arbitrating was in the executive office.
Yeah.
And the two funding members...
Public organism. I mean,
definitely, yeah, but the question was about the IMI, the neutral body, that the third party that we were mentioning.
Dr. Bolívar.
I'd like to make a short question to Manuel Duesco. It's a question: why primary care was excluded from this public call? Because I don't understand why only it was developed for hospitals. Innovation is not possible in primary care or in other sectors.
Yeah, answer is that they are not excluded. They are excluded from funding from the Institute Carlos III. They are not excluded from the network. It's very different. So if you are a private institution, you can participate in the network, but you have to pay for your travel. So your trip is on your own budget. But if you are really interested in the possible products of the network, then you'll be there probably. So again, as we say with the companies, don't be in the network just because you get some money from the government. Be there because you are interested in the results.
More questions? I have a question to Dr. Comella.
Sorry?
Yes, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Yes. Hearing you about the explanation about this this document. My question is that you have discussed in the group about who will cover the cost of the process of the licensing of the patenting, how will be the distribution, will be a responsibility of the investigator, will have the institution budget for cover this first step. We need first of all to have an agreement with a company. You have discussed this process or?
Yes, we have discussed that. And well, in fact, we are not starting from zero. I will say that many of our hospitals have patents and have licensed patents and exploited patents. And in general, the cost of the patent usually is paid by the foundation. If you can, you should make a perspective on the market. If there is a company that is interested in getting a contract on that patent, so this makes things easier, of course. Otherwise, I mean, if you think that your patent is good enough, I think you should protect them. So the final model is not established as a whole for the entire Catalan health system, of course. But there is some experience on that. What is really important to explain also is that the revenues, the real revenues that are redistributed, are the ones that remain after taking out all the costs associated with the patents. Okay? So when I was and at the same time, the 30% that is kept by the foundation should be dedicated to maintain the system ongoing. Okay? I'm not sure if I explain myself.
Sure, no. This, my question is, do they have any kind of harmonization of working at the institution on some time of then could be decided, well, after the process of the patenting and after discounted all of the costs, previous costs, then we make the distribution or before. Well, but only having,
the distribution
you have this case, discussed this matter, not only how we'll distribute the revenues, in not all of the process of the
Yeah, the costs are associated with the patent itself, and associated in general should be subtracted from the as a cost from the revenues.
Okay. Yes.
A question for you. That distribution of revenues, it's not only applicable to patents, I guess, but also to any type of transfer contract.
Yeah, of course.
That's
right. Yeah. This is inside. Important.
Yes, you have two questions here. First of all, here, Esther.
This is a general question addressed to the table, but perhaps particularly to what Angel said. I seem to conclude from your presentation that it was preferable to use a pool mechanism because that, in innovation, it was preferable to use a pool mechanism because that's the companies knowing the market and demanding what they need. If that's the case, wouldn't it make more sense that the government spends money in helping companies to find what they need than giving money to academia to actually keep pushing things that may or may not work? That's my general question.
I'm a strong believer of more than technology push to work on market pull. And in fact, one of the problems that is really happening in Spain is the subsidized companies are doing research or are working in innovation programs because they are subsidized. Now, in the new strategic research, the Ministry of Science is trying to change this, and the new calls, for example, I don't know if you are familiar with the most right now, which is going to be the most important, which is called Impacto. What does is that companies that don't receive money from the government. They receive a credit that they have to give back in 10 years. So right now, the companies that strongly believe that innovation is the right way, and they have identified these opportunities, are the ones that are submitting. And I also agree that probably governments should encourage companies or teach companies how first to organize the innovation, identify how to extract the innovation inside, because I know that we are losing opportunities, rather than funding companies to subcontract academia or fostering academia to to work with companies, but not in a way to put in value what the academia or companies are doing. I don't know if I have answered it. The key question is that we have been working many years in subsidized companies. And I have been working 5 years in a research center in UK, and in UK there's no subsidized. Companies do innovation because they have to do innovation. There are no subsidized for research centers. Margaret Thatcher in the 80s, she made private all the research centers. The center I used to work, it was funded in 1946, and there were funded 62 centers. When Margaret Thatcher made all them private, only 6 survived. They only survived the ones that really understand that they have to start doing value things to the industry, because there's no subsidized for doing research and fostering innovation. So I strongly believe that we have to work on that, but it's a long, long term in Spain, because it's very, very few time that we have been working in this area. But I agree with that.
Any comment you want to make also?
Where and how governments put money and efforts is key of the public policies. And evaluations sometimes has not been doing in R&D policies to say, okay, this is best than another thing. So there is a point. We must evaluate better public policies and R&D public policies first. Second thing is, okay, pull policies means give money to the enterprises. Push policies, give money to the academia. And now, at the European level, at the states level, there is a third one. This is put in the middle, at the partnership, public partner partnerships, IMI. IME, which is the third one. Work together at the beginning. Not think and transfer. This is energetically less sustainable than work together, co-creation, co-innovation. Second thing, not only is money everything. What can governments do without direct money? Public procurement and regulations. Pre-competitive public procurement regulations. 35% of the Catalan budget is from health system. A lot of money for workers, for salaries. But this in Europe, this is a lot of money doing. We have got the best health systems. Catalonia, I think, is one of the 3 best in the world, perhaps 5 best. I mean, I'm not saying this, and I'm not on the health system. People from one side say, well, the best health system in the world. Why don't you use this powerful to drive economy? But strategically, from the beginning, thinking strategically means, for instance, if you want to be the best technological medical technology or one of the best medical technology areas in the world, for instance, you can act strategically from governments. For instance, Israel government, 20 years ago, they had a strategy to do this and say, okay, I got a Technion. Technion is the Universitat Politecnica de Catalunya, the Tel Aviv, equivalent. Not equivalent, because Technion has the same budget that Cambridge. Okay? So, and they say, okay, I want to put, I want to start a new faculty of medicine, the best in Israel. Where is good this faculty? At the Polytechnic. In the middle of the Polytechnic. At the heart of the Polytechnic, with transversal programs. if you want to be the best in something, the governments can do something strategically. I think this Israel perhaps has is a very peculiar country, but we can do from the government something strategic, for instance.